Welcome to Signal and System lecture series. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain residue method to get inverse Z transform. So I have already explained two methods to get inverse Z transform. One is long division method and second is direct method to get inverse Z transform. Here in this session, I'll be explaining residue method to get inverse Z transform. Now, one thing that we need to keep in our mind, whenever Z transform is there in very big order of polynomial, in that case, we should go for a calculation of residue method. Otherwise, you can go for long division or partial fraction method if X of Z is there with lower order of Z. But if X of Z that is there with very higher order of Z, in that case, we should not go for residue method. So here you can see X of Z, that is Z to the power 18 divided by Z minus half, Z minus 1, Z minus 4. And question is, calculate X of N is equals to minus 16. And here, this is very important term which is written, X of Z converges for mod of Z is equals to 1. I'll explain what is the importance of this. But before that, first of all, we should know what is the basic formula of residue method. So first I need, let me mention here what is the basic formula of residue method. So X of N, by using residue method, we can calculate X of N, and that is summation residue of X of Z into X of Z into Z to the power N minus 1. And that should be at the pole of residue. Now see, this is in, when you see this formula at first sight, you will be finding it is very difficult to understand. But I'll explain that by this example, so it will be more clear. So let us apply this formula for this case, then it will be easier to understand how to solve this. So see here, for this case, now we will be calculating X of N. So X of N here, see residue of X of Z. So here we have three poles in X of Z, right? So poles are residue. So we need to understand here three residues are there. So poles are residue. So first pole is happening at Z minus half. So first I need to write residue summation. So first for first residue Z minus half, I am writing this. So Z minus half into X of Z, now I need to multiply. So X of Z, that is Z to the power 18 divided by Z minus half into Z minus 1 into Z minus 4, and this into Z to the power N minus 1, and this is happening at Z, at the pole of residue, means at Z is equals to half. And this is what summation of all residue. So we have two more residues. So plus, I need to write second residue, that is Z minus 1. So this will be Z minus 1 into X of Z. So X of Z is Z to the power 18 divided by Z minus half, Z minus 1, Z minus 4 into Z to the power N minus 1. And this is happening at residue Z minus 1. So I'm writing it at Z is equals to 1. Plus, now we'll have to consider third residue. So third residue, that is happening at Z minus 4. So third residue is Z minus 4 into Z to the power 18 divided by Z minus half, Z minus 1, Z minus 4 into Z to the power N minus 1. And that is happening at residue Z is equals to 4. So addition of this three residue, that is what X of n. Now let us simplify this. So we can say, see, this will get cancelled. Over here, this will get cancelled, and over here, z minus 4 will get cancelled. So after that, we will be having little simplified version of this. So we can have x of n now, and that is z to the power 18 into z to the power n minus 1 divided by z minus 1, z minus 4 at z is equals to half. I need to mention this every time. Plus, for the second term, z to the power 18, z to the power n minus 1 divided by, now see, z minus half and z minus 4 is there, and this is at residue, z is equals to 1. Plus, now see, for this third term, it will be z to the power 18, z to the power n minus 1 divided by z minus half, z minus 1 at residue, z is equals to 4. So this is what the basic x of n we have. Now see, here in this question, it is given we need to converge for z is equals to 1. So here question is what? X of z converges for z is equals to 1. So as x of n is converges for z is equals to 1, we don't need to consider these two cases. Only this case that we need to consider. But if it is not given, like x of z is converges for z is equals to 1, in that case we need to consider all three cases. So here we don't need to consider all three cases as x of z converges to 1. If it is the question like x of z converges for z greater than 1, means we need to consider these two cases. If it is given like x of z is converges for all value of z, then all three cases should get considered. But here, for this particular question, we don't need to consider all three cases. We just need to consider this as x of z, mod of z is converges at 1 value. So this is only the case which we need to consider here. So see, now we need to place z is equals to 1 in this basic formula. So if you apply z is equals to 1 in this basic formula, 1 to the power 18 into z to the power, means 1 to the power n minus 1 divided by 1 minus half, that is half, and 1 minus 4, that is 1 minus 4, that is minus 3. So this is what? 1 to the power 18, that is 1, and 1 to the power n minus 1 divided by minus 3 by 2. So we can say this is what? Minus 2 by 3 into 1 to the power n minus 1. So this is what solution for this one case only, where mod of z is converges at 1. Now see, what is the question? Question is, find x of n at n is equals to minus 16. So here, if you place for n, x of n is equals to minus 16, then we need to place n is equals to minus 16 here. So if you place this, minus 2 by 3, 1 to the power minus 16 minus 1. So 1 to the power minus 17 is 1. So this value will be minus 2 by 3. So this is how we can solve this. Now there could be a question like mod of z is converging for z is greater than 1. In that case, we need to consider these two cases. We need to solve by placing z is equals to 4 over this calculation. If it is like mod of z is converging at half value, in that case, this is only the case which we need to consider, where we need to place z is equals to 1 by 2 in this basic formula, and we can have solution. So this is what we need to keep in our mind when you calculate residue method to get inverse z transform. And this type of problems are so essential in case of numerator polynomial is having very high order. If it is happening in this way, in that case, we should be using residue method. So whenever numerator polynomial is having very high order, in that case use this method. This is easiest way to have a calculation of inverse Z transform in case of numerator polynomial is having very high order. Otherwise you should go for long division method or partial fraction method for a solution for inverse Z transform. So this is where we can use Z transform. I hope that you have understood this. And here I am concluding complete Z transform with this last lecture based on Z transform. Please give your suggestions. If something is required based on Z transform, please comment here. Definitely based on your comments, I'll try to place all those examples which is required here. Thank you so much for watching this video.